On a rainy Thursday night, the infamous Dr. Oz came to West Fields Memorial High School to have a frank conversation about drugs and alcohol with students and parents alike.
Inside a packed auditorium that seated at least a few hundred people, Superintendent of Schools Clara Brito Herrera and Mayor Felix Roque welcomed Dr. Oz and his staff to the venue before he took the podium.
I knew that we had the top, the mayor, to the bottom, or anybody involved in just trying to live a normal life, a community that I think is the perfect bullet base to tell the story. A little bit of all the spice, all the nutrients, all the things that could be bad, all in one place. So what better place to have a town hall that can speak for all of America? They know these types of events are taking place. My wife's church is having one in Philadelphia as we speak. I've been contacted by other groups interested in similar events, but we decided to televise from here because we thought we could tell the story of America from where we are. So you stand for America tonight. Thank you.
Dr. Phil Blanc, the Vice President of Research and Health Science Communication for Health Corps, a health organization Dr. Oz started that Memorial High School has partnered with, went through slides of statistics with the audience regarding addiction.
About the same amount thought that heroin and marijuana were addictive, but when it came to prescription drugs, it fell down again. And then we see that soda, they also don't really think that that's addictive. So a couple of points. First, you see that huge drop-off from heroin and marijuana down to prescription drugs. Maybe we need to clarify that, yes, prescription drugs can be just as or more addictive than some of these substances. And then isn't it interesting that the same amount who thought prescription drugs were addictive also thought soda was addictive. So maybe they're actually, not only do they see it as different from heroin and marijuana, but they also kind of trivialize it to the point that they think it's as addictive as soda.
Additionally, Dr. Michael Croupade, the medical director for the Dr. Oz Show, and Oz gave the audience a hands-on look at the effects drugs have on the body.
And the key thing about the brain is a real structure, right? You can go and pass it down. And we say that because Mike showed a slide, it's a chronic disease, and this is an organ that, you know how when you break your leg, you don't run so fast? When your brain isn't designed perfectly, and none of ours is, you get prone to certain problems. Addiction is one of them, which is why it's not a moral failing to have an addiction. A few of you put your hands up earlier when we asked about addiction in your family, and I'm going to come back to you in a second. Not to put you on the spot, but if you want to talk about it. You know, people often judge others who are addicted because they see that they're worse. But the fact of the matter is, it's like seeing someone who's got a broken leg not run fast. All it means is their leg was broken, they couldn't run fast. It doesn't mean they're any lesser, any more flawed. It just means they need help in a different way.
Dr. Oz also took live questions from the crowd, exclaiming that the last one changed his life. A woman who identified herself as Estella said that since some West New York families have to deal with the fear of deportation, kids often have nowhere to turn in the schools.
It's sad when we see that. Immigrants come from other countries. The kids, they have the parents. It just brings my heart to know that these kids sometimes they don't have anyone. No one to turn to. And these kids are just taking any medication that's in the medicine cabinet. What type of medication that is prescribed to a family member, right, for instance, will make someone feel good because they feel depressed. I don't know, I just want to know what kind of...
You just asked a question that changed my life. Why wouldn't you want to ask that question yourself? It's a great issue to know.
Because I didn't want to come to you.
On that note, Principal Scott Woolhab said the high school has two substance abuse counselors who are available to speak with students and teachers with complete confidentiality.
I'm John Heidis from the Hudson County View, the eye of the community.